Yeah? All right, Mitchell threw out. We over here by the island. Let's see what he's got. He hooked up right when we threw in. Maybe we could double up on him.
See what it is.
Like, see what it is. Could be a shark. Could be a bull red. Could be alligator. See what it is. Here he comes.
Jack.
Look like a jack.
Yeah.
It's a jack crevel, which is another awesome fish to catch. Great sport fish. Not good to eat, but they're awesome to catch. Good fighting fish. They're fast, fast, fast. Yeah. Wait till you see how pretty they are. Have you never seen one? I'm trying to get out of your way.
You're good.
Awesome. Oh, y'all. And the jacks and bull reds will hang together a lot. They love to be by each other. They love it.
Checking them all off the list today.
Yep. Check off every species. Get them all. Okay. Let me get in. I'm gonna get my net out. Ugh. And these things, pound for pound, are some of the hardest and fastest striking fish that are out here. They really are crazy, crazy, crazy fun. You tell me when you need the net, Mitchell. I'm gonna keep fishing.
Good thing I hooked him on a big rod. Here he
comes.
Be close.
All right. Now, y'all, these fish have unbelievable jaw structure. They really do. Let me hurry and get my pole in. Look how pretty that fish is, y'all. Woo! Nice sizing. This is about an average size for us out here. We get them a lot bigger, and they get some smaller. Now, when I used to fish in Florida a lot, I catch little bitty ones. We hardly ever catch those here. Most of our fish are about this size or bigger. Now, really cool, y'all, this fish. What's awesome about him is that, I don't know if you can hear it over all of the birds chirping, but he's got crushers in there. And look inside that mouth. He's got teeth. You can hear those crushers. Here, man, hold your fish. Awesome.
Inshore tuna.
Inshore tuna. But look how beautiful that fish is, y'all. Gorgeous yellow on him. These fish feed on everything that's out here, just like redfish would and trout would. Gorgeous fish. He's got that thing down in him. Let's get it out of there. And you can grab them up on the side of the gill. You don't want to hurt their gills, but you can grab them so you can get their mouth open. Look inside of there. And Mitchell's just using like a little open at night colored bait right here. Got them right in the corner of the mouth where we want to get them so we don't hurt them. But look at that, y'all. That is awesome, Mitchell.
Look at the big old pectoral fin on them too.
Yep, awesome fish.
Spear them back in.
Yep, and you always want to kind of spear them like that in. Tell them, Mitchell, why we do that?
Revives them really quick, gets the all the water and oxygen flowing right back into their gills, makes them shoot right off.
Yeah, gets them to go. Because the thing is, y'all, is that if you just put them in the water and just kind of let them go, those fish are speed fish. They need help to get going. Once it gets it kind of instinctively reacts them and they just take off and it makes them go. Because if you just let them go, they'll float back over and they...
There he is. All right. Okay, y'all. Now, part of Breton Island, believe it or not, just not the island part. Thanks, Speckle Trout. Not just the island part, but it comes down. Don't go. Coming towards the camera, girl. All right. But not only does the island itself have the island, but all around the perimeter of the island, they have all of these natural gas wellheads and these rigs, we call them. And they are structured for all of these fish to be able to live on. Redfish, speckled trout, triple tail, bull reds, regular reds. I mean, they got everything here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna hit a few of these wellheads and see what we got. I mean, that was like my third cast, caught that trout. A lot of times they get right by the structure and you got to figure out if they're on the up current side, the down current side, right up on this rig, or off the rig. It takes a little time because every single time the tide could be changing where it's falling instead of rising, or it's really strong and not really strong. You have to figure that out. But these things are a haven for fish because this is an open, vast gulf. So whenever these well heads and things are, you know, around a place like the island, it's just a place that all of these fish can hang out, feed, there's bait everywhere, and it just is very productive. All right, let me see if we can do this. Oh, now what I did, y'all, if you see, I switched up. I wanted to put a live shrimp on to see against these things what it would catch instead of artificial. Ooh, nice sheep's head. Woo, woo. Another species that's around there. That's a pretty one. Now, these like to eat the barnacles that are on all of these well heads. You see all that structure. It's got barnacles all over it and everything. And those sheep head will sit on those and pick up bait that comes by with the current. Or if it's things like barnacles or little crabs, they can get it. But watch this, y'all. Look at the teeth on this fish. If you've never seen one before. Uh-oh. Pooped everywhere. But here you go. Look at the teeth on that thing. What? That is a beautiful fish. Look how pretty that fish is. Some people call them convicts. But we're gonna put him back as a pretty fish. Get him back in there. Go, buddy. There you go, another species. There are all kinds of fish around here. Again, that was, I would have loved him. Oh, goodness. Oh, Mitchell's got a big old bull red on. All right, we're going. One of the things, y'all, what you gotta do is you gotta get away from the rig once you hook a bull red, because the bull reds, he's going around?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going, let him go. Like, don't keep the tension. Let's get him out of there. Let's see. You can see this whole, I mean, there's just so much structure around here for these things to get stuck on. Awesome. Y'all, I just missed a big ladyfish, and then he hooked up on this big old red. I think it's a big red. It's either a red or a drum, one of the ones.
Big old red fish.
Big old red? Awesome, look at that, y'all. Look how cool that is. Wow, that's so awesome.
All right, see if I can actually land this one.
Yep, you're gonna make it. Mitchell's lost a bull red already at the boat, a sheep head at the boat. Let's see. Nice. This is a good one. This is a great fish. Keep them coming, Mitchell. But y'all, that's the whole thing about this whole Breton Island area, is that it's just so vast and so many things to fish that you gotta come down and try it. It truly is a one place that has every single thing. Man, look at that fish. Wow. Get him up high. Look at that. Look how he looks. And that's a big red, y'all. Look at that thing.
Woo. He doesn't want to give up
either. Yeah, and they don't give up. That's the thing. These big old bull reds, they do not give up. They fight to the end. Right there. Got him. Got him. Woo! There you go, Mitchell. Ugh. Wow, look at that, y'all. Oh, Mitchell, that's awesome.
Oh, that's a big one.
Yeah, that's a big one. Look, and the hook was barely hooked in there. Here, oh, that's awesome. Look at that, y'all. Look how big that thing is. Here, hold him, it's yours. This is an awesome fish. Get him. Right there, you got him?
Got him.
Oh, look at that. So, y'all, look at this. This is amazing. This thing's awesome. It's got a little heart on its tail. Yeah. Must like Mitchell, maybe, I don't know. But the thing is that these big fish like this are all over around here. I mean, we just got to these rigs and we pulled up all these different fish really quick. You can come out here and do that also. Really cool, change it up. Now, Mitchell, that's a good one. You can put him back in. Now these reds, you gotta kinda help them out a little bit. You can't just throw them in. You gotta let them kinda get where they wanna go. But look, I'm gonna show you right now, y'all. What we're doing is, we're fishing right here, watch. I'm gonna show you how we're rigging this because it makes a big difference. To keep a shrimp on, everybody says it kills the shrimp. It doesn't kill the shrimp. I've been doing it for 30 years. What you wanna do is when you take that shrimp, you wanna put the hook in on a jig head. This is a 3/8 ounce jig head. And if you watch, you can see how the hook goes on the back part of the shrimp. You wanna get all of that meat on there. As soon as that shrimp tail hits the straight part of that hook, that's when you come out with it, push it up,
that jig head will hold that shrimp on there, and he's going to jump and everything, because it's not in his head. He's not going to die. He doesn't have any vital organs in this part. If you hit him in the head, he's going to die. And that goes on the bottom. It's bouncing. He's making that noise. They just pick it right up and come and get it. Awesome, dude. Great fish.
Something good.
Uh-oh. Mitchell's got a nice one. But this just goes to show, y'all, there's so many different species of fish that hang around these things. I mean, this is really like a hotel, if you think about it. And all the fish are going to be able to keep them away for now?
Maybe.
I can stop this, but I'm going to pull you out. Open up your, pop, don't let it pop. Let's get over there. I'm coming. I'm going. Just don't let it be tight.
Yeah.
Just open your mail. Or whatever. All right, where yet? I can't see a line. That's why.
I think he might have went like in it.
All right, wait, let's see. Just let him kind of work his way. Just keep the tension. Oh, he's through it.
Yeah.
So this fish.
There he goes.
He's out. Oh, okay. We thought the fish went inside the rig because they'll do that. They know that's protection in there. We got to chase him down a little bit. I don't know if it's because Mitchell's gear is not strong enough or he's not strong enough. I'm not sure.
Combo of both.
Combo of both, folks. He's nice calling
it. Red.
It's a big red?
Yeah.
Cool. Oh, man. Awesome. And oh, he spit it right there?
Yeah.
Awesome. Look, that just shows. Now that was a big old bull red. So we've caught trout, sheephead, catfish, bull red. I mean, it's insane the amount of fish that hang around these little things. It's really fun because you just go to each one and you throw out. They seem they want a little bit of live bait here. We're throwing out officials, not really getting them. But the live shrimp from Campos is really working good, so we're using that. So if you ever get a chance to come out, you get to go fish around places like Breton Island. It's actually a treat, y'all. I mean, it really is, because what happens is that you get not only to see something that is really unique and really special wildlife-wise, but also the fishing is just off the charts. There's not many places that are better, and I've fished all over the place. I mean, you can catch sharks, jacks, bull reds, speckled trout, stingrays. I mean, there's everything there. Everything. You catch lemon fish, which is cobia, right off from the island. If you went out into the Gulf, maybe another 15-minute run, and you're on mangrove snapper, red snapper. It's just it truly is heaven on the water. It truly is. So look, we're gonna put a link down below just to show you where Breton Island is. We'll have a little link for it and some of the stuff that we've used. But I hope you enjoyed this series. And, you know, we could have sat and caught trout all morning. We could have sat and caught sharks forever. Yeah. I mean, we could have done that. But what we wanted to do is show you everything that is out here that you can take when you get the chance to come out here and fish. So make sure y'all go. And if y'all want to check us out, BayouCharters.com. Me or one of my guides would love to take y'all out here and put you on an experience of a lifetime. Mm-hmm.